Again, everybody, welcome back to the Badger Stadium. It's game three in the Herder Memorial Hockey Final between the Badger Bombers of the Central Bialik Hockey League and the winner of the Labatt's Avalon East League, the Flatrock Flyers. Game one and two in St. John's last week see Badger win the first game by a score of 5-4, and the Flyers rebounding with a win on Sunday afternoon by a score of 5-2. Both Jack and I were in St. John's for those games, and we'll give you the highlights of those games right now. I'm Ted Patey, along with Jack Stucklish, your color commentary man for tonight's game. And Jack, in St. John's last week between the two teams, the Badger Bombers and the Flatrock Flyers, it was two great games and exciting for the fans in St. John's.
Yes, Ted, they had capacity crowds at the Brett O'Hare Arena in St. John's. I watched the first game. I thought it was the best game that I've seen all year, and probably for the last few years. Both teams were skating well, hitting well. Flatrock are a big team. You're not going to push them around. In the second game, they came out and they wanted to win. They had to win, and they did what they had to do, really, and came up with a 5-2 win.
And that, Jack, brings us back here, like you say, to the Badger Stadium. And there's a possibility we could have three games back here. Game three tonight, game four tomorrow, Sunday afternoon, and if necessary, a game on Monday night. That's a possibility with what we saw in St. John's last weekend. This could go to the limit.
I fully expect it to go to the limit, Ted, after watching those two games. Badger won 5-4, like we said, on opening night. But that goal, winning goal, was scored with 1:44 left in the third period, and it was on a long shot from the blue line by Kennedy, Russ Kennedy, that got the game winner. I think the goaltender was fooled a little on it, and only for that, that could have went into overtime, and it could be 2-0 or possibly still at 1-1 like we are.
Okay, Jack, just let's have a look at the lines here for Flatrock. Of course, the big line is Oates, Peddle, and Dumarez. Oates having played with the St. John's Capitals, and Peddle also some senior hockey experience, but Dumarez set all kinds of junior hockey records in the St. John's Junior A League. And we're looking at the second line of Bradbury, Sullivan, and Hocko. They're more or less like a defensive line. And of course, Jeff Sullivan, Kevin Parsons, and Derek Pelley, they pull up the slack on that third line. And we're going to see all three good lines.
Yes, Ted, I watched, like I said, the first time I've seen the Eastern Avalon League was last weekend in St. John's. I know Terry Piddle because he played against this league when he played with the Bonavista Cabots, and he was a going concern then, and he still is. He hasn't changed any. Derek Pilley, a native of Bishop Falls, we've seen him in this league, and we know about Danny Dumaresk and a few more players in there. They have good credentials, and like I said before, they're a big team. They're not going to be pushed around or intimidated. In the second game last week, as far as what I've seen, and like any game that you go to, naturally it's the team that retaliates, or the player that retaliates against the penalties, and this is what was happening to Badger last week. They Flatrock were doing the initial thing, and Badger were retaliating, and they got caught nearly every time.
Huey Hollett, the captain of the Badger Bombers, was back in action last week in St. John's after coming off a broken ankle, and we're going to see him again this week, and he's just getting stronger every game.
Yes, Teddy, he was only seen spot duty last week in St. John's. He didn't have too many shifts, but I talked with Yubi yesterday and today, and he told me he's on a regular line and he will be playing regularly tonight.
Okay, once again, game three of the Herder Memorial Trophy Final from the Badger Stadium, and we'll be right back after this important message with play-by-play of game three. Well, we're just about ready for the opening face-off as the two teams line up. And Jeff Wells gets ready to drop the puck for game three in this Herder Memorial Final. From the faceoff, Kirby Dumarez fires it over the Badger line. Bert Little fires it down. Flatrock Flyers zone. No icing on the play. There's a shot by Robbie Penny. Now there's another shot by Sullivan, and Langmead kicks that one out. Now the point. Puck over in the slot area. Lee Hocko fires it out to his own blue line and Eddie Oates. That's a shot goal. Partially blocked by Robbie Penny. And Dubres fires it out in front. Now Cleary fires it in the corner with number 66. Robbie Penny fires it in the Flyers end. The Bombers will make a change on the play. Now Eddie Oates at center ice. Up to Terry Peddle. Makes his way in the corner and taken out of the play by Robbie Penny. Now the play is blown down by the side of the net.
This is picked up dead where it left off to him. Flat ride. Robbie Penny really taking his man Terry Peddle into the board rather heavily. And we must say at this time that the talk is not working here at the stadium, so you're going to have to bear with us when we don't know how much time has elapsed or how much is left.
Now Bradbury, Sullivan, and Hocko line up for Flat Rock. The puck is about over center ice where Brent Sellers failed to keep it in. Now Heffeman. That puck is stopped by Bobby Bugden. Far behind Langmead. He leaves it there for Brent Sellers. And they fail to get it out over the line. Now Bobby Bugden. At the Flyer blue line, there was a weak shot. There's a shot out in front. Now Ron Harrell lets a shot go. There's another shot. He scores!
Badger really kept the pressure on for the first couple of minutes of this hockey club at this hockey game, and I think it paid off. I'm not exactly sure who put the puck on it, but I think it was...
Craig Tuck got the goal,
Craig
Jack.
Tuck, number eight.
A big rebound off the pads of Blair Langmead. And Tuck made no mistake in tucking that one home. And the Bombers are up by a score of 1-0. From the faceoff, Russ Kennedy fires it over to George Penny. And he takes number 79, Derek Kelly, out of the play. Now Kevin Parsons. Fires it out to center ice for Keith Loader, leads it for Russ Kennedy, and that's intercepted by Steve Cleary. Now Jeff Sullivan fires a shot blocked by Kennedy and Robbie Penny. Robbie Penny taken out of the play by Kevin Parsons. Now Russ Kennedy. Here's a 2-on-1 break. Kennedy fires it across in front, and John Goss broke up the play. Now number 16, Parsons, fires it up to Derek Pelly. And he's taken out of the play by George Penny. Kennedy leads it behind his own net for Robbie Penny. Up to Stevie Burns. And Yubi Hollett. Knocked down by Ray Hefferman. And we have an offside on the play, Jack. And as you mentioned, the time clock is not working, so we'll just play by ear.
Instead, that goal was scored by Craig Tuck from Price and Rodney Howell. And it came on a big rebound from Rodney Howell's shot from the point, and Tuck was right in front to put it home.
On the draw, Hocko shoots it in the corner, and Bobby Bugden. Oh, he's hit hard there by Eddie Oates. There's a shot. Puck's behind the net. Oates tried to get it out in front. Now Rod Howell intercepts the pass and fires it up to Yubi Hollett. Now Dumaris fires it behind Roger Kennedy with Burt Little. Failed to pick it up. Now Terry Peddle out in front and fired across. Dumaris failed to tuck it home. Now Burt Little over the Flyers blue line. Langmead shoots it to the corner. Peddle taken out of the play. And now rink wide pass up to Terry Peddle. He's up the center ice. Taken out of the play by Bobby Bugden. Rod Howell shoots it right back out. Now Hocko fires it in over the Badger blue line with Roger Kennedy. A pass for Craigie Tuck, and he failed to pick it up at the Flyers blue line. Now Warren Sullivan fires it around the net. John Goss takes his man out of the play. And now there's Bradbury. Failed to get around George Penny, and the puck is back at center ice. Al Kennedy lays it for Robbie Penny.
See, this game has really started off at a fast pace. Bodies been flying everywhere, but quite a number of hard checks from more so by the Badger Bombers, I think, to They're back on their game in the first 4 or 5 minutes of this hockey team, of this hockey game.
All the Bombers lead it by a score of 1-0. It's early in the first period. There's a shot. Kennedy gloves that one, leaves it for George Penny. And Craig Tuck and referee Jeff Wells blows down the play, and we'll have a face-off to the right of Roger Kennedy.
We have a capacity crowd here again tonight. This is ever since the playoffs have started, this stadium has been jammed to the rafters.
Bradbury, Sullivan, and Hockel line up for the face-off just inside the Badger blue line. Kennedy. Now George Penny at center ice lets a shot go. Oh, and Langmead. That puck trickled through Langmead's pads, Jack, and that was a close one. Now Robbie Penny keeps the puck in, fires it in the corner. It's behind the net. And the Flyers fail to put it outside their own blue line. Now number 10 fires it. There's a shot. And a save by Langmead. Off the stick of Craig Tuck. Robbie Penny almost intercepted at the Flyers blue line. There's another shot. He scores! Number 10. Craig Price puts the Bombers up 2-0.
That line again, they had a Price and Duck. They've been flying all ever since the game started. They've been flying and getting their chances along with young Manuel, and they stayed off for the first 2 goals. I would say probably about 5 minutes gone, period.
Well, as you mentioned, that's the second goal by the kid line. And the Bombers are up 2-0. Al Sullivan, Parsons, and Pelly out for the Flyers. From the faceoff, Bobby Bugden shoots it in the Flyers' territory. And it's left behind the net for Jeff Sullivan. Now Derek Pelly. Up the center ice to Kevin Parsons. Pucks in the corner, Sullivan. Bars it out to Sellers, there's a shot. And a stick save by Kennedy. Now Sullivan, back to Derek Pelly behind the Badger net, and Steve Burns failed to put it out. Now Sellers, watched here by Russ Kennedy. They'll try and freeze it on the boards here for a face-off, but the puck is loose, and Derek Pelly comes out in front. He scores! Derek Pelly on a wraparound from the side of the net, Jack. Put that puck to the side of Roger Kennedy, and the Flyers are right back in this game.
Yes, they had a lot of hard work there by Pelly and number 19, Jeff Sullivan. And it paid off in a lot of hard work in a goal that Roger Kennedy made a couple of good saves there in that flurry, but that last one eluded him from the wraparound. There's about 5.5 minutes gone in the first period.
From the faceoff, Yubi Hollett loses the draw to Kirby Dumouriez. Al Hollett fires it in Flyers territory. We're Wayne Sullivan. Off the board, takes his man out of the play, and clearing. Fires it around the net to the end boards. There's a shot stopped by Robert Penny, and Yubi Hollett has a partial break. There's Hollett going in, and a big save by Lightning. Score! Yubi Hollett!
Yubi Hollett had a clear-cut breakaway, Ted. He fired the first shot with the stop. And he followed up, and that puck came back out. And I'm not sure if Yubi Hollett scored or Robbie Penny was right in front.
All the Bombers go up by a score of 3-1 early in the first period.
Flatrock goal, Ted, was credited to Jeff Sullivan, number 19.
From the faceoff, back to George Penny. That center ice, there's a long shot over the top of the net. And Burt Little taken out of the play by Ray Hefferman. Al Peddle up to Eddie Oates. That center ice is over the Badger blue line, and it's an offside call.
And Wayne Little and Terry Peddle have something going there. Tip coming in over the blue line. The score is 3-1 for Badger. There's 6 minutes, a little better than 6 minutes gone now in the first period. I think this may get a little chippy before tonight is over. We have that kid line out again now for Badger. Did both first two shifts they've been on, they've scored.
in this Herder Memorial Final from the Badger Stadium. That is brought to you by Cable Atlantic, Grand Falls, Windsor. There's Heffelman. Shoots it in the corner behind Roger Kennedy. George Kennedy takes Sullivan out of the play. And Gregory Price loses the puck. There's a shot. He scores! Number 20, Robert Bradbury. Fire the weak shot and over the shoulder of Roger Kennedy and trickle in the net, Jack.
Instead, that was a shot that Roger should have had. He put the glove on it. It went straight up in the air. He lost sight of it. It came down and bounced in across the line for Flatrock's second goal. Robert Bradbury, number 20, let the shot go from just outside the faceoff circle.
All the Flyers right back in this game. And from the faceoff, Kennedy. Donkey stick off, trying to clear that pass. There's a shot. It's loose in front. They bang away at it. And Kennedy covers up.
A bit of pushing and shoving going on here in front of the net. Now, Kennedy came out behind the net to try to clear the puck. When he hit it with his stick, he broke his stick, and he's rather lucky to get the puck to come along the ice from the shot from the blue line, and he was able to cover up. And they started pushing and shoving in front, but no penalties will be called out of this.
Well, that last goal, Jack, coming around the 13-minute mark. As the teams line up, to the left of Roger Kennedy.
7 minutes gone in the first period.
10 minutes gone, so Jack looking at the Flatrock Flyers there. If we look at their big defenseman, John Goss, who was injured most of the season, and just back for the finals, and John Goss can give a consistent game, game in, game out, an excellent defenseman. Out from the faceoff, Bobby Bogdan. Over to Stevie Burns. Puck is shot right back in by Sellers. Now Robbie Penny, his pass is intercepted. It's Kevin Parsons, and he failed to put it over to Jeff Sullivan in front of the net. Now Russ Kennedy fires it across in front of Langmead, and Robbie Penny fires it right back in behind the Flyers' net.
There's going to be a penalty call to Flatrock. It'll happen back here when the Bombers are on the way out. I was mentioning at the time, too, that Badger missing number 5 on defense, Terry Paul, who was slapped with a 2-game suspension by the league for an altercation in Flatrock on last Sunday. Terry, this year, everybody knows that Terry plays an aggressive game, but this year he really played hockey, and in my mind, he was one of the best defensemen that was with the team, and I know that they're going to miss him down stretch.
All the Bombers will make a change here and put out their kid line of Manuel, Tuck, and Price with Robbie Penny and Bobby Bogdan back on the blue line. Face off to the left of Blair Langmead. From the draw, back to Robbie Penny. There's a shot, and that stopped right at the blue line. Back to center ice. Now Bogdan. Craig Tuck. Makes his way, there's a shot across the front, only just wide. Manuel just fired the puck inches wide. Now Craig Tuck, in the corner, there's a shot. And Pricey fanned on that one. Now they bang away at him in front of the net, and number 22, Idiot. Leads it for Dumas, he's blocked by Craig Tuck. Comes out behind his own net, failed to clear the puck. And a shot right back into Greg Price. Price fights for possession of the puck against Lee Hocko. Now there's a shot, and that was just wide. Now Price back to Penny. There's a weak shot, and Steve Cleary fires it off the glass and down Badger territory. Kennedy leads it for Robbie Penny, and he takes Dumas hard out of the play as Robbie Penny makes his way up the center ice. Lohler fires it in the corner, and Heffelman fires it off the boards, and Penny fires a shot. That's a weak shot, and Langmead makes the save. Out of puck from behind the net. Out to the blue line, and we have another penalty on the play.
I think there's a penalty being called against Badger this time. They touched the puck, and the whistle went. So I think there was a trip in front of the net there by Wayne Little. Score is 3-2 for Badger. We keep looking at the clock, and
There's no score up there and no time, only 3:13 written out. And it's a bit confusing at times.
Well, hopefully we'll have the clock back in action for tomorrow night's game. As the teams line up for the face-off from the draw, John Goss over to Heffernan. Makes his way up the center ice. Fires it in behind the Badger net. And number 10, taken out of the play by George Penny. Now there's a shot by Yubi Haller from just outside the Flyers blue line. A Langmead stares that to the corner. Now Yubi Haller. Back to George Penny as the Bombers try to kill off this penalty. Now the Flyers on the power play will have Terry Peddle, Eddie Oates, Ray Heffernan, and John Goss and Dumouriez. Now John Goss over to Heffernan at center ice, up to Eddie Oates. He failed to pick up the pass, and Robbie Penny fires it outside his own blue line. Now Penny, who fires a long shot right over the glove of Blair Langmead up into the end blue, Jack, and we'll have another face-off down in the Flyers' end.
Instead, I noticed John Goss then was upset there at the blue line. He just fell down and went to the bench immediately. I don't know what the nature of his injury was before the season ended, but it looked like he was hurting on that play.
From the face-off, Terry Peddle fires it back to Steve Cleary. Behind these no net, watched by Russ Kennedy. Cleary, rink wide pass to Eddie Oates at center ice. He's over the Badger blue line. Gets around Bobby Bogdan out in front. And Robbie Penny fires a deep in Flyers territory as Lee Hockle. Picks up the puck in his own end, up to Dumouriez. A rink wide pass to Terry Peddle. He's over the Badger blue line. Back to Eddie Oates. There's a shot and rapids wide. Now Russ Kennedy up to Craigie Tuck. Tuck loses that center ice to Terry Peddle. Peddle over the Badger blue line, watched by Robbie Penny, makes his way in behind the Badger net. Dipsy doodles around, loses the puck to Bobby Bogdan. And now Cleary in the Dumouriez. Dumouriez behind the net to Peddle. Peddle tried to get it out to Dumouriez. Over on the side boards. Back to Peddle. He misses a check by Robbie Penny. And Burt Little fires it off the glass, note over his own blue line. Now Bobby Bogdan at his own blue line. And the Bombers are back at full strength. George Penny fires the puck in Flyers territory, and Brent Sellers. Watched there by Stevie Burns and Kevin Parsons. Intercepted there by Gregory Price, picks it up again, and Rodney Howell takes him out of the play. Al Penny, taken out of the play hard there by Kevin Parsons, was Greg Price. Now Keith Loader makes his way over the Flyers blue line, gets in front, there's a shot, and a big save by Langmead. Al Price tries to get away from big number 7, Brent Sellers, and Keith Loader. Comes up at the puck, back to Price. Price fires it out in front to Stevie Burns. And that was a high pass. And George Penny bumps Herbert, Ray Heffernan. And the puck shot back behind the Flyers' net. Al Sellers fires it over the glass. Jack with the face-off to the right of Blair Langmead. And the Bombers lead this one by a score of 3-2.
That was a good shift there by their second line. The Bombers there, Burns and Loader, really had the head of him in there on that play. I would say there's about 6 minutes left in the second period, and the score is 3-2 for Badger. It's settled down since the opening 6 or 7 minutes, Ted. They're getting around now to playing hockey, I believe.
Well, we had two NAHA officials in the time box down there tonight, Jack, and they're looking after this game with stopwatches. As we mentioned, a problem with the clock at the Badger Stadium. Now from the faceoff, Cleary, taken out of the play by Burt Little. Hawk is up to center ice and Stretch Hayden. Fires it back for Cleary. And the play is whistled down on an offside.
With the option of Perry Paul, Dave Butt is dressed for the Badger defense. So far, he hasn't seen any action. Hubert Holla tonight was only received a spot duty in the two games in Flat Rock, but he's been playing a regular shift tonight, and he had one really good chance earlier in the game.
Well, UB Hollett, of course, Jack, moved up on line number one once again for this game here tonight. And now Gregory Tuck, Barry Manuel, and Greg Price, the kid line. And for the Flat Rock Flyers, we have Tony Hockle, Warren Sullivan, and Robert Bradbury. Bradbury will take the face off. He wins the draw. Fires it in Badger territory with Roger Kennedy. Takes it behind his own net. And George Penny. Up to center ice to Craig Tuck. He's over Flyers blue line, over to Barry Manuel. As the Bombers go on the power play, Gregory Price behind the Flyers net loses it to John Goss. And a shot out to center ice. As the Flyers would try to kill off this penalty. Alabama Bombers up to the Flyers blue line. Craigie Price taking it on the board by John Goss and Robbie Penny. At center ice, that's intercepted by Lee Hockle. Hockle over Tony Hockle, there's a shot, and that was just wide. Now Bradbury with a shot, and that was just wide. Now Robbie Penny at his own blue line up to center ice.
Did you know that letting your car idle pollutes more than driving does? So remember, don't leave your engine running.
Just one of hundreds of things that we can do for our environment.
Let's do it now!
For your free booklet, contact Environment Canada.
Now Roger Kennedy will make a slight adjustment to his goalie pads as they line up for the face-off outside the Badger blue line. Also alongside of us in the telecast booth tonight, we have one of the top senior referees in the province, and we're talking in the person of Gerard Hayes. Gerard Hayes, of course, does the lines for the American Hockey League in St. John's at home when the Maple Leafs are at home. Probably later in the telecast, we'll get a chance to talk to Gerard and get his comments on the American Hockey League. Now from the face-off, Rod Howell. Over to Bobby Bugden, up to center ice to Russ Kennedy. He fires it deep in the Flyers' territory. And number seven, Ray Heffernan, fires it out to Terry Peddle. He's stopped there by number nine, Russ Kennedy. Kennedy over to Burt Little, leaves it for Keith Loader. Behind the Flyers' net, tries to come out in front. There's Bobby Bugden. Back to Keith Loader, over in front to Russ Kennedy. There's a shot, and that was just wide. Now the Flyers on the move. Peddle couldn't get outside of his own blue line. There's Keith Loader. Fires it in front. There's a shot. And that was just wide at Burt Little. Fights for possession of the puck in the corner against Brent Sellers. And now Burt Little comes out behind the Flyers net. There's a shot by Bugs and he scores!
The hard work there, dead in front of the net. Russ Kennedy had a great chance prior to that and just missed. Little kept digging in the corner and finally fired it back to Bugden all alone. And his shot, there was no way stopping that.
All the Bombers go up by two as they lead the Flyers by a score of 4-2 late in the first period. And we have, Jack, a capacity crowd here tonight and a lot of fans from Flat Rock. And, of course, they're both showing their appreciation for both teams. From the face-off, Kennedy shoots it off the glass, down in Flyers territory, and Lee Hockle. Hockle, watched there by Wayne Sullivan. Taken out of the play by Hockle, puck shot across front of the net. 5:09 remaining in the period. And the Bombers go up by a score of 4-2.
And it looks like there's penalties being called, but the referee, I thought he was going to call a penalty, but he hasn't moved as yet. Now he's moving to the penalty box. Robbie Penny's going for sure. I will say the double penalty is being called on
and
this one.
And Kevin Parsons, number Kevin 16 Parsons. In the Flyer.
They were roughing it up by the blue line, and it looked like Robbie Penny didn't want any part of it, but the referee called them both. I thought he should have.
Well, Jack, they're two big boys, and I can tell you that number 16 of the Flyers, Kevin Parsons, can be a tough guy on the ice for the Flyers because he is the guy that looks after his team when the Flatrock Flyers are playing, and he can scrap with anybody. From the faceoff, there's George Penny with a shot and a save by Langme. Now Jeff Sullivan. Off the center ice, over the Badger blue line. There's a shot and a stick save by Roger Kennedy as Yuri Hutter. On the men for the Bombers. Over the Flyers blue line, gets in front to Jacob. And Wayne Sullivan failed to put it home. Now the puck is out in front. Langme will glove that and we'll have a face-off, Jack, with just a little less than 5 minutes in the first period.
And again, I know I'm maybe prejudiced, but another great play by the Bombers with Yuri Hutter, who really seems to be on his game tonight. Young Jacobs and Sullivan, they had a great chance there and just missed. And just prior to that, the puck came back to George Penny at the point. Unfortunately for George, it was rolling and he shot it up high.
They'll line up for the faceoff to the right of Blair Langmead. Craig Tuck loses the draw. To Steve Cleary. Cleary fires it over the Badger blue line and Tony Hockle failed to keep it in. Al Tuck up to Greg Price. Over the Flyers blue line, taken out of the play by number 25, Steve Cleary. Al Puck is shot up to Warren Sullivan. And Sullivan taken out of the play by Penley, and we have penalties on the play.
I think we have a penalty to Badger, Ted, on this play. Is going to Barry Manuel. Ted is going to get the gate here for Badger. So Flatrock down 4-2 will get a chance to go on the power play, and you can bet that that they're going to have Dumouriez with Oates and Peddle out on this power play. Maybe not to start, but they'll be out before the 2 minutes are up.
While the Flyers go on the power play, Hocko, Bradbury, and Sullivan. Now there's George Penny in front. And it's an offside call.
Number 16, Parsons. 2 minutes for offside. Double penalty score 23. Badger penalty number 6, Manuel. 2 minutes for charging. Double penalty 3:56. Under 4 minutes left to play in the first period.
So there's a little less than 4 minutes left in the first period. Table to score 4-2. And Flatrock Flyers are on a power play.
From the face-off, puck is fired behind the net, up to the Flyers' blue line, and John Goss fires it over to Steve Cleary. He's watched there by Craig Tuck, and a rink-wide pass up to Sullivan. Oh, and he just missed a check by George Penny. Now, Bradbury fires it in the corner. There's a shot, and Roger Kennedy comes up with a big glove save on Robert Bradbury.
Roger put himself in that bad position that time, Ted, and he certainly made up for it with the point-blank shot there right in the glove. Roger has the tendency to roam a lot, and sometimes he gets caught at, but a lot of times he can make up for it, too, being so quick as what he is.
Face off to the right of Kennedy. As Eddie Oates takes the draw for the Flyers against Craig Tuck. Tuck wins the draw. Up to Ross Kennedy, and he fires at the end of the ice for Langme. We'll leave it for number 25, former star in the St. John's Junior A Hockey League, Steve Cleary. Cleary fires it up to Eddie Oates. He's at center ice, over the Badger blue line to Dumouriez, and that's intercepted by Bobby Bogdan and fired right down the ice. Now Cleary, watched there by number 9, Ross Kennedy, and Tuck. Is it for John Goss? Goss up here to Dumouriez, and that's intercepted by Craig Tuck. Al Craigie Talk fires it over to Russ Kennedy. Half stopped by Steve Cleary. Cleary up the center ice to Terry Peddle. A high shot. Kennedy gloves that one. Fires it right down in Flyer territory. About 2 minutes left in the first period. As Lee Hocko lines up behind his own net. Makes his way out front to Kirby Dumarest. Dumarest up back to Lee Hocko over the Badger blue line. And he's stopped there by George Finney. And the here's in front of Dumarest. There's a shot. And he was just wide. Now Hocko gets it out in front. Brent Sellers keeps it inside the Badger blue line. There's Dumarest over Lee Hocko. Back down with a high stick.
Little Lee Calder hit on that high stick. He knocked it down and the play seemed to carry on and before it was called.
Well, Jack, the referee for tomorrow's game, of course, is the person I just mentioned, Gerard Hayes. And Gerard, the caliber of hockey in this Central Bialik League, as we're seeing here tonight between Badger and the Flyers, is just tremendous.
It's great to see, Ted. It's great to see senior hockey in a way come back because this is really competitive and it's real good hockey. And like I said, it's some of the best hockey this year.
Gerard, this is what it's all about, local senior players playing for the Herder.
Well, there's no doubt. It's great to see all the fans come out as well, Ted.
All from the face-off, Rod Howell over to Robbie Penny. Fires it up to Keith Loader at center ice. He's over the Flyer blue line, makes his way in the corner, and he's stopped there by Sellers. Sellers failed to keep it out, and Rod Howell fires it in behind the Flyer's net. Now Keith Loader behind the Flyer's net. Fires it out the slot area, he scores! Craigie Price, number 10 from Keith Loader.
Craig Loader did all the... on that one, Ted. He kept after it and finally it paid off, and he popped it back to Greg Price, and he had made no mistake. He went to the stick side, high to the stick side, and there was no chance.
And now the Bombers go up by a score of 5-2.
Ted, this capacity crowd right now are really enjoying the results of this first period. I would think there's probably about a minute and a half left into it.
All from the face-off.
Number 10, Price. Six by number 4, Howell. Number 24, Loader. Howell goal, 126.
Greg Price from Rodney Howell. Craig Loader, Jack. And like you say, Price, he made no mistake when he let that one go.
It was high to the stick side, Teddy. He wasn't any more than 25 feet out to the left of up the goaltender. Keith Loader did the bulk of the work on that, Ted. You had to watch Keith Loader to really appreciate his moves. He's a digger and probably one of the better players on this hockey club.
From the face-off, Bobby Bogdan fires it off in the Flyers, Amor Ray Hefferman. Up to Jeff Sullivan, stopped by George Penny. And now the puck's back at center ice, and Burt Little fires it in Flyers territory. Hollett taken out of the play by Kevin Parsons. Parsons makes his way up the center ice. Oh, to Jeff Sullivan, there's a shot, and that's gloved by Kennedy. And he fires it out to center ice. Yubi Hollett up to Wayne Sullivan, over the Flyers blue line. There's a shot! Oh, and that was just wide. A nice pass from Yubi Hollett. And Sully failed to put it in. Now the puck's back at center ice. And Burt Little fires it up to Wayne Sullivan. He leaves it for Yubi Hollett, and that's intercepted by Jeff Sullivan. George Penny fires it across ice for Ray Heffman, fires it deep in Badger territory, and Roger Kennedy fires it off the boards, out to Burt Little, across to Barry Manuel, he's over the Flyer blue line, fires it in the corner, and Bradbury behind his own net. And there's the buzzer for the first period. And after one period of play, Badger Bombers lead by a score of 5-2. And Jack, you give us a rundown of the scoring now in that first period.
Yes, Ted. Greg Tuff opened the scoring for Badger from Greg Price and Sullivan. With 18:29 left in the period. Time, but that's unfortunately because of the clock failure that we have. The second goal was scored by Greg Price from Barry Mangan and Greg Tuck. Again, we don't have the scoring of the Flat Rock goal. It's difficult to get the announcement back where we're to her. The Badgers' third goal was scored by Yuli Hollett from Rob Penny. Flat Rock scored again and again. We don't have the score. The last two goals for Badger scored by Bobby Bogdan and Craig Price.
Okay, after one period of play, the Badger Bombers lead by a score of 5-2. Well, Mel, as chairman of senior hockey in the province of Newfoundland, we're at the Badger Stadium tonight for game 3 of the Herder Memorial Final. It's strictly local senior hockey players that's in the Herder Final tonight. This is what the trophy was put up for originally about 56, 57 years ago. Your comments.
Well, Ted, it's nice to be at the Badger Stadium tonight and Badger's first entry into the Herder Trophy and we're into the finals, as you say, and we're back to square one. We're back what it was all about in 1935 when it started. And I tell you, as a senior person involved with hockey, it's very gratifying indeed to realize that here we are. And we've witnessed a darn good brand of hockey, and I think the fans have enjoyed themselves so far.
Well, let's just go back to the start of the senior finals in the Bialy Hockey League here in Badger and in the central area. Let's see, knocked out the Gander Flyers in four straight. Badger knocked off Cornerbrook in four straight. It was an excellent final that we saw between Badger and Let's See, and that's the kind of final that will really stir up interest for the Herder next year.
It certainly will, Ted. And as you know, we started off this year and we outlived ourselves in senior AAA and we priced ourselves out of the business. And last year, there was some interest shown in Herder. And I advised the parties concerned if they wanted to play for the Herder that to attend a senior meeting, which they did. We've had two excellent leagues this year. And hopefully that we're looking forward next year to getting some more divisions back in senior hockey. And hopefully next year we'll have four or five different leagues. And we'll grow from there.
Well, just talking to George Friday a couple of weeks ago in St. John's, this is the thing that you just mentioned, George, is hoping for at least five divisions around the province with all the final winners in each league coming together for the Herder. One thing we got to mention, Mel, looking around here at the Badger Stadium tonight, is the capacity crowd. And this is what we will get in the smaller communities, more so than the bigger cities.
Well, see, Ted, you can go back just a few years. I mean, since I've been involved, and you know, when I was up here just a few weeks ago and came up here to one of the games, and it was just unbelievable. And I mean, if we can get the fans out and get, you know, for this type of hockey, well, that's what it's all about. We haven't got to get imports come in and take over our local talent. We're trying to improve hockey in Newfoundland. Now, I'm not saying there's not a place for imports. You could bring in a coach, a playing coach, or whatever the case might be. But we're back to our grassroots. We're back to day one. This is the type of hockey that the fans want. This is the type of hockey that we want. And hopefully, like I said before, the next year, different leagues will want to come in and participate as well.
Mel, when the Herder was put up again this year for senior hockey, there was some positive reaction. There was a lot of negative reaction. As chairman of senior hockey, what did you think about the negative reaction?
Well, Ted, I thought it was terrible. In fact, I went to the Grand Falls Advertiser and I expressed my concerns. You know, and to talk about the smaller towns and now the Herder was being put down, sort of. And, you know, I mean, that's not true. And the people out there that don't know the difference, you know, it's terrible. I mean, this trophy was put up in 1935 for the best type of senior hockey in Newfoundland. And that's what we have today. In fact, the type of senior hockey today was far better than what it was back in 1935. There was no artificial ice. It was played on natural ice. There was no leagues. And they put a couple of teams together and play off for the Herder. And to make comments like that, I think, is terrible. And we're trying to build up senior hockey, and hopefully those negative reports will have no effect on us.
I first experienced the excitement in small communities in the town of Port of Bath about 4 years ago when they won the Herder, and of course this is what we're experiencing in the town of Badger this past week.
Well, Ted, there's a prime example. Port of Bath that was in and won the Herder. That's only a small town. Now, granted, they had imports, but I mean, we want Newfoundland hockey. We want to give hockey to our local fellas. And if we can come up with this type of hockey that we're seeing today, I mean, that's what it's all about, you know? And we're in twos, and hopefully, like I said before, next year, the other teams will come back, and we'll have a four or five team league.
Mel, thanks for your comment.
It's a pleasure.
We'll be right back after this important message with play-by-play of the second period.
By these standards, I guess we didn't give you that much when you were a child.
Oh, I know, Mom, I know.
Oh, we all really have it good, you know. Makes a person feel a bit guilty sometimes.
I know what you mean. That's why Dave and I cut back a bit on gifts this year, and we've put the money towards sponsoring a foster child in Africa. It doesn't cost that much through Foster Parents Plan.
Maybe we didn't do such a bad job of raising you after all.
Call Foster Parents Plan. Toll-free 1-800-268-7174.
While both teams are back on the ice for Game 3 in this Hurdle Memorial Final between the Badger Bombers and the Flatrock Flyers. And Jack, if you can give us a rundown now off the first period.
Yes, Ted, we tried to do that at the end of the first period, but unfortunately all our times and we never had all the goal scorers. But at 1:31, Badger opened the scoring. Craig Tuck from Greg Price and Rod Howell. At 4:42, Greg Price for Badger from Barry Manuel and Craig Tuck. And Flatrock came back at 5:23 with a goal from Jeff Sullivan, from Brent Sellers and Ray Hufford. At 5:55, Yubi Hall scored for Badger from Rodney Howell. At 6:32, Flatrock answered, made it 3-2 with an unassisted goal by Robert Bradbury. And at 14:51, Bobby Buckner scored from Wayne Little and Russ Kennedy. And at 18:34, Greg Price for Badger from Rodney Howell and Keith Loader. There were three penalties apiece in the first period, and a shot trying goal by Flatrock 16 and by Badger 16 and by Flatrock 9.
Okay, as we get ready for the second period of Game 3, we'll just haul Gerard Hayes in here to referee for tomorrow's game. And as I mentioned, Gerard does the lines for the American Hockey League pro games in St. John's when the St. John's Maple Leafs play at home. Gerard, you had a chance to come to the central area last year and referee a game here. And at that time, I thought you were pretty impressed with the caliber of play.
Oh, definitely, Ted. Last year I did Badger, I think, in Bishop Falls in the semifinals. And it was a great caliber. I was impressed with the fans and how knowledgeable they all were, and respected the referee. It was a great feeling to be here.
Okay, Gerard, and we'll see you in tomorrow's game. And I'm sure we always get a good game from Gerard Hayes. Well, as both teams line up at center ice for the face-off, and referee Jeff Wells gets ready to drop the puck, and the second period will be underway.
Both teams at full strength to start this second period.
On the face-off, Steve Cleary fires it up to Eddie Oates. He's stopped there by George Penny at the blue line, and now Oates will try it again. Robbie Penny in behind his own net. And Wayne Sullivan comes up with the loose puck. Oh, fires a lead pass up to Yubi Hollett, and he just failed to get in the clear. Now the puck is back, shot into Badger territory, and Roger Kennedy fires it off the glass, but not over his own blue line, and Lee Hockel fires it in front. Now Eddie Oates over the pedal, and he failed to tuck it home. Now the puck behind the Badger net. Dumarez taken out of the play by Wayne Sullivan, and they'll freeze it along the boards for a face-off.
And Pedro Oates and Dumarez kept up pressure on the Bombers from the start of this period. It wasn't for a good play by George Finney. It could have been closer at 5-3. We now have a change in goaltending. Number 32, Tony Walsh, has replaced Claire Langmead.
Well, Jack, Tony Walsh, no stranger to provincial senior hockey, as he played a number of years with the St. John's Capitals along with Roger Kennedy. And you'll see some great goaltending from Tony Walsh, who originally, his dad comes from Buckens, and Tony has already played on a Herder, as well as his father back in the old Buckens Miners days. All the puck is in the Flyers' end. And Bradbury, taken out of the play there by Tuck. Loose puck, Hefferman. Over to Bradbury, up to number 10, Warren Sullivan. Puck is at center ice, back to the Badger blue line. Now Rod Howell. stopped there by Bradbury as Bobby Bogdan shoots it over the Flyers' blue line. Al Sullivan, Warren Sullivan, loses it to Bogdan, and we'll have another face-off early in the second period.
Did I watched Tony Walsh play the second game in Flatrock series, and he was outstanding from what I've seen of him.
Jack, I'm not sure, but I think Tony Walsh Jr. and his dad are the only two players, father and son combination, that's on a Herta Memorial Trophy. So a number of players in the lineups tonight that have already played on a Herta Memorial Trophy. Out from the faceoff, Tony Hockel fires it over to Warren Sullivan, and it's blowing down at the blue line on a delayed offside.
Warren Sullivan a little late getting in there, Ted, and him and Manuel came together inside the blue line, falling. He touched the puck, created the offside. It's a 5-2 hockey game. We had to keep reminding you what the score is because there's no clock here working, and it doesn't take long to forget probably what the score might be on that.
All from the face-off, Rod Howell at his own blue line up to center ice. And Craig Tuck taking out the play by Steve Cleary. Now Big John Goss fires it off the boards, and Bogdan fires it right back in. Howell stopped at the blue line. Rod Howell in the Craig Tuck, and then the Manuel loose puck in front, and Walsh covers up.
Manuel, Price, and Tuck again creating problems. This is the best line on the ice right now. Every time they're out there, they seem to create a lot of problems for Flatrock Flyers.
All they line up to the face-off to the left of Tony Walsh. There's Penny with a shot. And that was just wide to the other side, and George Penny fires it right back in. And Keith Loader, watched by John Goss. There it is in front, and a shot. And Kennedy failed to get a good shot away, and the puck is fired down back in Badger territory. Roger Kennedy leaves it for Robbie Penny. Makes his way up to his own blue line, loses it to Pelly. And now Jeff Sullivan ties it up along the end boards, and another face-off early in this second period as the Bombers lead this one by a score of 5-2.
I think we have a problem at the other end, Ted. I think the glass has popped out down there, and the stadium management are going to have to do some repair work down at the lower end by Roger Kennedy.
Well, as we wait for the repairmen to come out to rectify the problem, we will take a short break, and we'll be right back after this important message. Off to the left of Roger Kennedy. Eddie Oates wins the draw, back to Lee Hockel. There's a shot, and that was just wide. Now Robbie Penny up to Steve Burns at center ice. You're over the Flyers' blue line. He's watched by Brent Sellers. Puck's by inside the net, and Walsh covers up once again.
Brent Sellers and number three, Steve Burns, had a few words with Ted that time in the corner.
With number seven, Brent Sellers, and of course, Sellers, like you say, another player, a defenseman, always playing a defensive hockey game in, game out. On the draw, Sellers loses it to Keith Loader. Back to the point to Robbie Penny. There's a shot, and that was stopped by Terry Peddle. Now Dumarez, the lead pass up the Peddle. He fails to pick it up, and Russ Kennedy intercepts. Now Dumarez over the Badger blue line. And that's intercepted by Keith Loader. Loader's up the center ice. He's over the Flyer blue line. Stops. Fires it across. The pass intercepted by Eddie Oates. Now there's a race for the puck. Dumarez taken out of the play by George Penny. Puck shot in behind the Badger net. And Roger Kennedy leaves it for number 14, Penny. He fires it off the glass. And that's stopped there by Kirby Dumarez. Now Eddie Oates comes out, fires it in front, and that's stopped by Penny. There's a shot off the arm of Roger Kennedy, and the puck's back at center ice. Lee Hockel fires it back in Badger territory, where Stevie Burns, behind his own net, fires it up to center ice, and Tony Walsh leaves it for Hefferman. Hefferman, watched by Wayne Sullivan, fires it off to John Goss, up to Tony Hocko. Hocko over the Badger blue line, and an offside on the play, Jack. And it's early in the second period, and the Bombers lead this one by a score of 5-2.
Play getting a little ragged there now. Ted, passes are not flicking from either side. Must point out that in the first period, in the early part of the second, that George Finney has been a standout on the Badger defense.
From the face-off, Hefferman over to Goss. There's a shot! And that's an offside, Jack. And as you were mentioning,
George Finney, yes, former BE, formerly played in 80 and 81, I think, with Grandpa's Cataract. He knows what this is all about. He's been a member of the Herder team, as well as Juby Hall, 1 year that he played in this league.
And, of course, number 22 for the Flat Rock Flyers, Eddie Oates, has been in the thick of things regards of Herder Memorial play. Eddie hadn't played a number of years with the St. John's Capitals, Jack, before he was transferred to Labrador City as a member of the Royal Newfoundland Constabulary. And Eddie Oates not only plays hockey, Eddie Oates puts a lot into hockey in the Avalon East communities. And as a matter of fact, he's coaching a Bannerman tournament in Gander this coming Monday. Now there's a race for the puck. Tony Wells fires it off the glass. It's stopped by Sully. He's out in front. And John Goss makes his way up to center ice. He's over the Badger blue line. Tries to fire it out from the corner, and a stop by Bobby Bugden. Now a loose puck picked up by Warren Sullivan.
Ted, other players that have played, like you said before, including Tony Walsh and Kennedy, Badger goaltender, have played in the Herder before.
Well, Roger Kennedy's played on a number of Herders, and not only with the St. John's Capitals, but Roger's also played in Stephenville and had some good years of hockey there.
I think this was put into right words when Mayor of Badger, Greg Coleman, said that these teams are Newfoundlanders, and probably for the first time it's being played for by Newfoundlanders.
Now from the face-off, Greg Price fires it back behind his own net to George Penny. A loose puck and Steve Cleary. Up to Kevin Parsons, and he's taken out of the play by Robbie Penny. Now George Penny intercepted, there's out in front, and a shot to the side of the net, and Roger Kennedy will cover up for another face-off.
Roger Kennedy had to be really sharp there, Ted. There was a great chance by Flat Rock on that play, but again, there was a couple of hard checks thrown out by Robbie Penny.
Well, Robbie Penny just took big number 16, Kevin Parsons, had to play, and Kevin Parsons, hard to take out of any play with the size that he's got, and a pretty good hockey player. Out of the lineup for the faceoff, Jeff Sullivan will take the draw against Craig Tuck. On the faceoff, Tuck wins the draw. Back to George Penny, up to the Flyers' blue line, and back to center ice to Robbie Penny and Steve Cleary. Fire the pass up to Kevin Parsons. Out back in behind the Flyers' net. Craigie Tuck to Tony Walsh. He kicks it ahead to number 25, Steve Cleary. And now it's fired out in front, and Barry Manuel's shot was stopped by Lee Hocko. Now Lee Hocko up to Derek Pelly. To Kevin Parsons, he winds up for the shot, fires it in front, and Manuel shoots it right back up the center ice. Steve Cleary for the Flyers. As they make a change, Robbie Penny over to brother George. That's a shot goal, that's wide. And Price fires it in the top. To the side of the net, and Tony Walsh covers up, and we'll have another face-off early in the second period with some pushing and shoving to the side of the Flyers' net.
Yes, Terry Peddle took exception to talk going in there and trying to get at the puck, but which Walsh had covered in the crease. Score here, I would think it was about 7.5 to 8 minutes gone in the second period, and it's still 5-2 for the Badger Bombers over the Flat Rock Flyers.
Well, they'll line up for this face-off to the left of goaltender Tony Walsh. Eddie Oates will take the draw against Russ Kennedy. Now Sellers fires it behind Tony Walsh over to Tony Hocko. Hocko watched here by Steve Burns. And now Sellers. Fires it off the glass, out to Bobby Bogdan. There's a shot! And a big save by Tony Walsh. Now Hefferman. Down at center ice, over the Badger blue line. Fires a rink-wide pass. And Dumouriez failed to pick up the puck as they fight for possession of Sellers. Behind his own net, watched by number four, Ron Howell. And now a loose puck kicked out in front, and Stevie Burns. Fires a loose puck. Back in Flyers territory, and Hefferman. Watched by Keith Loader. Loader and Hefferman go to the ice. And now John Goss taken down the board by Russ Kennedy. Eddie Oates up to Dumouriez over the Badger blue line. Bobby Bogdan intercepts. And a puck shot back to Ron Howell. Howell up to Russ Kennedy at the Badger blue line. And that's stopped there by Terry Peddle. Now Peddle fires it off the board. Back to the Badger blue line, and George Penny will try it. He's at center ice. Fires it in the Flyers' territory. Tony Walsh. Fires it over to number 25, Steve Clearing. He's taken out of the play by Robbie Penny. Now there's a shot, stopped by John Goss. Up to Warren Sullivan. And now Bert Little at center ice over the Flyers' blue line. There's Sully, fires it across in front. And Bradbury fires the puck down in Badger territory. Roger Kennedy fires it off the boards. Tony Hocko tries to pick it up and is fired in front of the Badger net. Al Yubi Hollick at center ice to Bert Little. Over the Flyers blue line. There's a shot and a pad saved by Tony Walsh. Now Robbie Penny fires it in the corner to Yubi Hollick. There's a shot out in front. And Sully couldn't get a good shot away. As they rough it up to the side of the Flyers' net.
Things are getting a little rough here now. Ted Burt Little is getting into a deal with number three, Lee Hocko. Tony Walsh had a shove at Little. Little always seems when he's on the ice to create a little bit of a disturbance. And that last sequence of action there was probably the best we've seen in this second period. We'll have to watch one more here or two. That's Ray Hefferman and Loader. Pete Loader from Badger. They were going at it pretty strongly for the whole shift that they had just a few minutes ago.
All the Bombers lead this one by a score of 5-2. And we're about midway in the second period. As they line up for the face-off, to the right of goaltender Tony Walsh. On the draw, back to the point, Bogdan takes a shot, and that stopped in front. Now Craig Tuck loses possession of the puck. John Goss falls on the puck, and we'll have another face-off to the right of goaltender Tony Walsh.
We have this kid line under again, Ted, with Manuel, Tuck, and Price. They created all kinds of problems in the first period. Had a couple of three goals in the first period. And they're supposed to be reckoned with all year in their own league and so far in the three games this year.
On the draw, there's a shot by Bobby Bogdan and a pad saved by Tony Walsh. Al Parsons feeds a pass up to Derek Pelly. And we have icing called against the Flatrock Flyers.
Bagger lead this game to 5-2. I would suspect about 10 minutes gone into the second period. Again, we have to remind you that the clock is now working and we have to assume how much time has elapsed in each time to stop at your play.
On the face-off, there's a shot by Rod Howell. And Tony Walsh makes a nice glove save once again, Jack. And Walsh showing some great goaltending in the second period.
Yes, Walsh is keeping the score where it is, 5-2.
Tony Walsh always yelling out to his players, Jack, getting them on the move. As Tuck lines up against Jeff Sullivan. Sullivan wins the draw, back to Sellers. He's watched there by Craig Tuck. and fires it off the glass into the bomber's bench, and we'll have another face-off inside the Flyers' blue line.
Yes, Tony Walsh, getting back to Tony Walsh, like I said, he's always yelling and bawling. He's a real quarterback back there, bawling at his player, telling him to go to play to go, behind the net, get him.
On the face-off, over to Bobby Bogdan, fires it in behind the Flyers' net. Oh, it's out in front, and Manuel failed to get a shot. There's a high shot over the top of the net. Now Tuck, taken out of the play by number 79, Derek Pelly. 11:28, the time. There's a shot right in front, and Walsh comes up with another pad save of Yubi Holland. Roughing penalties as the teams play four aside, five aside, coincidental penalties. And now Dumarez fires it in behind the Badger net, where it's left for George Penny. Stopped there by Terry Peddle and Davy Jacobs. Makes his way up to his own blue line. He's at center ice. Tony Walsh fires it out, couldn't keep it out over his own blue line, and Craig Loader. Taken out of the play by Hefferman. Al Yubi Holland. There's a loose puck and a shot. And another save by Davy Jacobs. And Tony Walsh comes up again with another big save as Yubi Holland and Steve Cleary rough it up.
Penalty to be called here, Tib, to Hubert Holland and Cleary. But before that, Badger had a great opportunity to really put this game away. But Tony Walsh was really equal. He really came up big there on two shots right in front, no more than 15 feet in front of him.
All this game is brought to you by Cable Atlantic, Grand Falls, Windsor. It's game three of the Herder Memorial Trophy Final between the Badger Bombers and the Flatrock Flyers. Eddie Oates will take the face-off to the right of his own goaltender, Tony Walsh, and Russ Kennedy, former star player in the St. John's Junior Hockey League, will take the face-off for the Bombers. On the draw, Oates wins the face-off, back to John Goff behind his own net. Over to Tony Hockle, off to Terry Peddle, back to Hefferman, and now John Goss. A rink-wide pass to Terry Peddle. He's at the Badger blue line. Taken out of the play by George Penny. And play goes on. Russ Kennedy leaves it at the side of the net, and goaltender Roger Kennedy will hold on for another face-off about midway through the second period.
Terry Peddle and Robbie Penny have something going up there. Ted, Peddle tried to dig Robbie, but he couldn't do it, and they both ended up in the corner, and after that, they just pushed and shoved, and but there's nothing going to come of that, because Terry Peddle is not the type that that's going to take any penalties for his team. He's one of the better players that he got, and if he's gone, well, you lose the best player.
Bradbury wins the draw. Back to Sellers. There's a shot. Kennedy gloves that one, leaves it for Robbie Penny. Al Sullivan. Bradbury back to Hocko, taken out of the play by Penny and Stevie Burns. And the puck is shot right back in Badger territory. Al Keith Loader failed to pick up the pass at center ice. And Ross Kennedy goes into the boards with Lee Hocko. Al, there's a shot, that was just wide. Kevin Parsons fires it up to Bradbury. There's a race for the puck. There's a pass. And Sullivan failed to tuck it home. Al Keith Loader behind his own net. He's stopped by Kevin Parsons. There's a shot by Bradbury. And a big save by Roger Kennedy as they rough it up once again behind the Badger net.
Bradbury had a great chance that time in front of the net, but he never got much wood on the shot. And it ended up being an easy save for Kennedy. Again, a little chippiness in behind the Badger net. But again, nothing is going to come off this. It's just a little pushing and shoving. And now each team will change players. There's probably, again, 14 minutes probably played in the second period, but score 5-2 for Badger over Flatrock. Capacity crowd here, and they seem to be enjoying every minute of it. Now George Penley picks up a penalty for the Badger Bombers as referee Jeff Wells skated to the Bombers bench and signified the penalty after Penley had already been sat on the bench. While they'll line up now for the faceoff to the left of Roger Kennedy.
With the absence of Perry Paul intended this game, Badger addressed Dave Button as their fifth defenseman. Now we see that there's a penalty being called to number 10, Warren Sullivan, on Flatrock. All this comes after the play has been blown dead, and doesn't seem any reason for it.
Jack, referee Jeff Wells certainly called an excellent game tonight, and he's letting them play hockey. Out from the faceoff, puck is up to Davey Jacobs. He's taken out of the play by Lee Hocko. Now Jacobs. Fight for possession of the puck with Lee Hocko. Shot in the Flyer territory, and Tony Walsh leads it for Sellers. Kevin Parsons taken out by Burt Little. And now there's Derek Pilley with a shot, and he fanned on it.
Badger penalty number 11, Holland. Flatrock coming through 25 spares. 2 minutes, he's corrupting. South of penalty is 9:48.
9:48. 2 minutes for roughing. Now there's Davey Jacobs. And he fired in front of the net. Burt Little lets a shot go. Davey Jacobs out in front to Sullivan. And Tony Walsh covers up once again. And Lee Hocko takes Davey Jacobs out of the play beside his own net.
And things are getting a little rough back here now. Big Lee Hocko really upset Jacob after the play was blown down. I think what they're trying to do is probably establish something for the third period or tomorrow.
Well, there are penalties on the play. And Lee Hocko and Jacobs both go off. No, Jacobs remains on the ice. It looks like Lee Hocko.
Lee Hocko was delayed hit on Jacobs. The play was already blown down, and Walsh had the puck, and he just came barreling in here and really, really upset Jacobs.
Well, now the Bombers will go on the power play as the Flyer sends out Eddie Oates and Terry Peddle up front, and Big John Goss and Ray Hefferman back on the point. From the face-off, Oates wins the draw. Bobby Penny keeps it in. Over to the side of the net, and Walsh will cover up. And we'll have another face-off to the left of goaltender Walsh, with the Bombers leading this one by a score of 5-2.
All the scoring this game has taken place in the first period. And I would think we're well past the halfway mark. And there's no score in this period.
Al Price in the tuck. Tucky in front. Oh, that hit the side of the net. Al Greg Price back in the tuck behind the Flyers net. There to the side. Rod Howell failed to put it in. Now Eddie Oates. What a two-man break with Terry Peddle. Over the Peddle in front. And a big pad saved by Roger Kennedy. Out of Bombers. Barry Manuel leaves it at his own blue line for Bobby Bogdan. There's a shot. And another big save by Tony Walsh as John Goss fires a deep in Badger territory.
Been great goaltending here now, Ted. First by Kennedy and then by Walsh. Great save.
Now Rod Howell in his own end makes his way to his own blue line. Up the center ice. Tony Walsh leaves it for Ray Hefferman, and he fires it off the glass. Al Bradbury fires it deep in Badger end as the Flyers are still killing off this penalty to Lee Hocko. Now Bobby Bogdan off to Keith Loader into Ross Kennedy. Here's a shot and another big glove saved by Tony Walsh, and some good goaltending.
Yes, shot taken by Shot taken by Bobby Bogdan from the right side there, Sid. And a great glove saved here by Tony Walsh. Flatrock are doing a lot of complaining to the referee. I don't know what it is. They're complaining that the puck went over the boards on the far side and touched by a fan that came right back in. It certainly looked like a fire bandit fight. Tony Watts certainly coming up big here in this second period. He hasn't allowed a goal since replacing Langmead to start this period.
Off from the face-off, Hocko. Over to Warren Sullivan, and he fires it over the center line. Bobby Penny. At his own blue line, up to Bert Little. Bert Little makes his way up to center ice, makes a nice move to get around Tony Hocko. Shoulder flyer, blue line, back to George Penny. There's a shot. And a stick save by Walsh. They fail to keep it out. Now Robbie Penny, let's go, a shot. And it's loose in front. They bang away at it. And Walsh covers up for another face-off with the Bombers leading 5-2. And Jack, just some goaltending, great goaltending by Tony Walsh.
Great goaltending on this end of the rink, Tib. And let's not forget Roger Kennedy. When he was tested there earlier by Terry Piddle, the two-on-one, he came up with the big save, too. But Walsh has been tested more often, and when you're tested more often, you tend to get more to show, you know, just what's happening. Badger is pouring it on Walsh, but he can't get nothing by him.
Al Bradbury will take the draw against Russ Kennedy. On the draw, Bradbury back in the cellars, behind his own net. He's watched there by Jacobs as he fires it over to Warren Sullivan, up to Bradbury. Al George Penny fires it right back deep in Flyers territory, and Lee Hocko fires it off the glass, and the end blues, and another faceoff. To the right
of the glass and hit the top of the boards up there and had to be blown down for a faceoff. I think there's 15 minutes gone in this period, and they've got an announcement. There's 5 minutes left in this period. The score remains 5-2 for Badger, with all the scoring taking place in the first period. And Walsh has been outstanding in this period. You just can't get anything by him.
I was a little bit surprised tonight that Coach Joe Maynard started Blair Langmead. Now, Langmead is a top-notch goalie, but when you're in Herder finals like this and with Tony Walsh with all this senior experience behind him, I thought Walsh would get the nod tonight.
Well, Walsh was a pickup from another team in that league, Ted, and I guess they figure, well, Langmead got us this far, so we'll go with him.
Now the puck is in front as Walsh fires a loose puck over to Russ Kennedy. Kennedy tries to get around Lee Hocko. Take it out of the play by Hocko. And now he makes his way to his own blue line. Up to center ice, fires it over to Derek Pelly. There's a shot and the pad saved by Kennedy. Now Jeff Sullivan fires it in behind the Badger net, where George Penny fires a lead pass up to Davey Jacobs, and the Bombers will be called for icing.
Again, Kennedy at the other end was there when he had to be. That was another quality shot, but Tony Kennedy, over the last 2 years, he's been playing with the Badger Bombers, that has proved to be one of the better goaltenders in the province.
On the draw, Roger Kennedy gloves the puck, fires it over to center ice, now Bert Little. There's a race for the puck, and John Goss takes Little out of the play. Now UB Hollard tried to get it out to his point man, and that's stopped by Terry Peddle. Now Bert Little in the play is blown down as Terry Peddle got hit with a stick, Jack, and we'll see just what happened.
Yes, UB Hollard hit him with the stick there, Ted. It was unintentional, but I don't think the referee seen what happened. Maybe the linesman did, but the referee certainly didn't see. He was back onto the play. There doesn't seem to be any blood or anything, but and there'd be nothing called on this play.
So we'll have a face-off to the left of goaltender Tony Walsh.
seems to be something wrong with Tony Walsh's equipment there, Ted.
Well, I think what it is, Jack, it's the ice. In front of the ice.
You need a few repairs there on the ice. Maybe a chip gone out of it or something.
Well, Oates, Peddle, and Dumouriez has been their big line as Joey Maynard, number 14 now, skates on the line in place of Terry Peddle. On the faceoff, Wayne Sullivan paws it out in front. Puck is kept in behind the Flyers net as Steve Cleary paws it over to Hefferman. A lead pass to Joey Maynard on a two-line offside.
But he was in the clear, but it was a two-line pass. Rodney Howell tried hard to get it, and had he touched it, he would have put him onside. This place is filled up again tonight, Ted. Quite a crowd on hand, and like I said, it has been since the playoffs started, even in the intermediate league and now in the Herder.
Off from the face-off, Hefferman over to Cleary at his own blue line, moves it up to center ice, fires it in the corner, Rod Howell. Fires it off the boards, another race for the puck as Burt Little and John Goss. Little, you'll be hollered. Oh, taken out of the play there by John Goss. Now the puck is over to Hefferman. He gets it out over his own blue line where Rod Howell. Couldn't get it back out. Number 77, Terry Peddle, leaves it for Kirby Dumouriez. Dumouriez out in front. There's a shot by Cleary and a stick save by Roger Kennedy. And the puck's out over the Flyers blue line. Now Rod Howell fires it in behind the net. Taken out of the play by Hefferman. And Oates. Oates couldn't get it out. Now Warren Sullivan. It's over the Badger blue line. Tries to get around Bobby Bogdan. And that's intercepted by Craig Puck. Puck fires a rink-wide pass. Price failed to pick it up. Now Lee Hockel. Back to center ice, up to Eddie Oates, and he loses it to Robbie Penny. And he fires it in behind the Flyers' net. Oh, and Tony Walsh got taken out of the play by number 8, Craig Tuck. And we have a delayed penalty against the Badger Bombers. Now Dumouriez, there's a shot. And that was just wide. And the Bombers will take a penalty for interference on goaltender Tony Walsh. As yes. Craig Tuck hauled the skates right out underneath him.
Yes, and it was lucky for Hefferman that that he couldn't have got away from down here because he went after Tuck, and except for the play going outside the line, I think he would have been called the retaliation there. There's a lot of action here happening behind Ted that has not been seen at the moment. He's on the way off there. Hefferman had another slash at Craig Tuck near the penalty box. And then goaltender Tony Walsh put his stick up into the manager's face during the Badger.
Badger penalty number 8, Tuck. 2 minutes for interference.
Now there's John Goss with a shot. And a pad save by Kennedy.
2 minutes.
Now Lee Hackle. Behind the Badger net. Circles out to the front. There's a weak shot. And Kennedy holds up. Now Robbie Penny and Lee Hockel go at it. There's Robbie Penny and Hockel. Two big boys, Jack, and they both can take care of themselves.
Yes, this is a tough one here, Ted. There's nobody going to go in to separate those guys yet. They're too big to get in there. And Punch has been thrown now over the line to play it. And this is all coming with less than 2 minutes left in the second period.
Well, they'll go off for fighting, no doubt. Lee Hockel and Robbie Penny. And Jack, they had to call that one a split decision.
Yeah, there was a few punches early and nothing late on that one, Ted. They never really got going. Here's the call. 5 minutes for fighting and a game misconduct. So there's 1:56 left in the second period. The score remains at 5-2 and face-off deep in the Badger end.
Well, they'll line up for the face-off to the left of Roger Kennedy. As Russ Kennedy will take the draw against Eddie Oates. Kennedy wins the draw. Penny failed to get it out. Now Big John Goss over to Oates. And a puck is in the corner. Hefferman back to Eddie Oates. There's another penalty against the Badger Bombers. There's a shot by Goss into Eddie Oates. He's taken out of the play by Bobby Bugden. And another penalty call to the Badger Bombers.
And now it looks like the Bombers are going to be 2 men short now. And their defense is starting to whittle down now with the two already gone. And George Penny in the box. So they're down basically right now to about three defensemen. So Dave Butt, who is dressed for tonight's game, probably will be pressed into action now. Dave Butt, I must say, he hasn't played all year, but he's been practicing with the team.
All the Flyers are on the power play. There's John Goss, fakes a shot over to Steve Cleary. Cleary, watched there by Ron Howell. Now there's a shot, and that's blocked by Ron Howell. And a race for the puck. As Cleary gets it back to Goss, that's center ice. There's a shot, and that was wide on an offside call.
This will come all the way back, Ted. I think it was an intentional offside. The referee pointed all the way back this way. And now Kennedy wants to get at somebody. The play is getting a little chippier late in the second period.
All Roger Kennedy having words with number 11, Kirby Dumores. As they move over to the left of goaltender, Roger Kennedy for the faceoff.
Roger doesn't mind the heavy going, Ted, now that he has a backup. Before they had the backup goaltender, he was kind of restricted. A lot of players were taking runs at Roger during the year, and he couldn't do anything about it. Now that they got Sugaroo on loan. Tortoise, playoff. Sugaroo replaced him in the last game of the series and played well.
Paul Bradbury wins the draw. It's back to Warren Sullivan. Now Derek Pelly fakes a shot. Back to Cleary. Cleary over to Pelly. There's a shot. And a stick save by Kennedy. 1 minute remaining in the second period as the Flyers are on the power play. Now there's Bradbury with a shot. Now it's back to Cleary. Cleary back to Sullivan. Sullivan watched there by Rod Howell. That guy went in front. And Sullivan back to Cleary at his own line. He winds up with a shot, and that's high over the Badger net. Now Keith Loader failed to keep it out. And Derek Pelly. Now to Steve Cleary at center ice. They're backing over the Badger blue line. And Keith Loader intercepts the play. Buck out center ice. He's hauled down there by Warren Sullivan. Sullivan taken out of the play by Bobby Bugden. Dale Freeze at the line of the boards with less than 1 minute left in the second period.
Ted Badger really getting in penalty trouble now. On that last play, Roger Kennedy got called 2 minutes for roughing. So they're going to go into the third period short-handed 2 men. And they're already short-handed 2 men. They're going to carry over situation now.
Well, both teams will make a change as the Flyers remain on the power play and the Bombers will try to kill off the penalty.
There can't be much more than half a minute left in this second period. The score remains 5-2 for Badger Bombers, but they are 2 men short.
Craig Tuck, Bobby Bugden, Roddy Howell, as Eddie Oates wins the faceoff and it's back to John Goss. Goss over to Jeff Sullivan. There's a shot, and Kennedy tries to fire it up the ice, and the buzzer goes for the second period. And at the end of this second period, the Badger Bombers, they lead the Flatrock Flyers by a score of 5-2, Jack, and no scoring in that period.
Yeah, nothing to report in that period in the way of scoring. There were many, many penalties. We don't have a count on them, but we will have them before the next period, third period starts.
Well, once again, at the end of the second period, the Badger Bombers 5 and the Flatrock Flyers 2. for play in this third period of Game 3 of the Herder Memorial Trophy Final between the Badger Bombers and the Flatrock Flyers. All the scoring, Jack, done in the first period, no scoring in the second, and the Bombers lead it by 5-2.
Yes, Ted, in the first period, the score ended up 5-2. Both teams were called for three minor penalties apiece. Badger shot Flatrock 16-9. And in the second period, there was no scoring, as we already mentioned. Badger took eight penalties in that second period. Flatrock were assessed six. Flatrock, who shot Badger 14-13. And for 27 seconds in this third period, they're going to be 2 men short. And after that, they'll be man short for a minute and 4 seconds.
Well, Jack, we'd like to welcome all the media in Badger tonight. Terry Hart of Kicks Country, Roger Barnett, CKCM, and Jim Brown of the Advertiser. And they're joining us in the box up here from our telecast. And always nice to see the media come to the hockey games.
Yes, Ted, we've been looking forward to this all year, and we finally got them here.
Off on the faceoff, Bobby Bogdan fires it out to center ice. And John Goss off to Brent Sellers. He loses it to Craig Tuck. Tuck back to Ryle Howell as the Bombers will kill off the remaining seconds in this penalty as the Flyers try to get closer in the score to the Badger Bombers as they're down 5-2. Al Kennedy behind his own net fights for possession of the puck with Eddie Oates. Al Kennedy will cover up way out of his net, and we'll have a face-off to the left of Roger Kennedy.
Yes, George Penny has returned to the ice, Ted, so now there's less than a minute left in the remaining penalty, and that'll be one man short. Flatrock, I think, has the score on this opportunity right now to get back into the game. They're down 5-2, and time is starting to work in the favor of the Bombers.
They'll line up for the face-off to the left of goaltender Roger Kennedy. At Brent Sellers, now playing on the forward line. Sellers, normally a defenseman. And now Craig Tuck at center ice. The speedy player lets a shot go. That's just why. Sullivan fires it in the end blues, and we'll have another face-off outside the Flyers' blue line.
They have Tuck and Sullivan out there killing the penalty line with Brogdon and George Penny. As we mentioned before, the Badger are down to four defensemen right now with Dave Butt still not seeing any action up to this point.
Craig Tuck will take the draw against Bradbury. On the face-off, Bradbury back to John Goss over to Steve Cleary at his own blue line. Back to Goss up the center ice. Over to Sullivan. Makes his way in the slot area. Back to Goss. There's a shot. And that's just wide. Cleary keeps it in the corner. And number 10, Warren Sullivan, taken heavily into the board by George Penny. Now, Craig Tuck fires it deep in the Flyers' territory as Goss behind his own net. Watched by Wayne Sullivan. A rink-wide pass up to Bradbury. And that's stopped by George Penny. Now John Goss fires it into Badger territory for George Penny. Fires it off the boards to Sullivan. Sullivan fires it deep in the Flyers' end. As there are a few seconds remaining in the Bombers' penalty. Now Steve Cleary stopped by Davey Jacobs at center ice. He's over the Flyers' blue line. And he's hauled down by Cleary. No penalty on the play. Al Bradbury and Jacobs fight for the puck along the boards. And as far deep, up behind Badger net, and the Flyers will be called for icing.
Dave Jacobs was going in there 2-on-1, but he got hauled down, Ted, and the referee just didn't call anything on the play. He was hauled down from behind on that play. Wayne Little was on the right side, and he tried to get a pass back to him, but he just couldn't do it. They successfully killed off all the penalties. Now both teams at full strength.
Well, less than 18 minutes left in the game, and the Bombers lead it by a score of 5-2. Al Sellers, once again back on the point. As the puck is barred up behind the Badger net, and the Flyers once again will be called for icing.
Flyers have to get back into this game, Ted. They're going to have to get down. And like you said, we have now less than 18 minutes left in the third period, and they're down 5-2. They're going to have to get some sort of an attack down in this end at Roger Kennedy. Some discussion going on up on the far end there between the referee and linesman.
Well, they'll bring the puck outside the Flyers' blue line for the face-off. As a matter of fact, back to center ice. Well, they'll drop the puck at center ice. Russ Kennedy and Jeff Sullivan on the face-off. Kennedy wins the draw up to George Kennedy. At center ice, there's Russ Kennedy over the Flyers' blue line. A pass for Keith Loader. Now Stretch Hayden. That's a shot! Goal! Score!
That was tipped in by Russ Kennedy, I think, on a shot from the blue line. It looked innocent enough, but it was almost offside from the Roarers that he did. So it was just deflected in by Russ Kennedy, and that makes the score now 6-2 with probably 17 minutes left in the game. Now the crowd are really starting to get into this game. I think they sense that maybe Badger are going to go up 2-1 after this one.
Well, Russ Kennedy puts the Bombers up 5-4 as they lead us 6-2. Now Hayden fires it up to Keith Loader. All this Stevie Birds, he's taken out the play by Eddie Oates. Keith Loader. Watched there by Steve Cleary, and they'll freeze it on the board for another face-off with about 16 minutes left in the game.
A little bit of chippiness going on again up there. That scoring play was Russ Kennedy from Greg Hayden and George Penny. It's nice to look around this stadium, Ted, and see it being full for every game since the playoffs started. They're standing about three deep behind in the standing area, and all the seats are filled. It looks like there's 600-700 people there right now.
On the face-off, Craig Tuck in the Flyers' corner, taken out of the play by Eddie Oates. Now Dumarez makes his way to his own blue line. Up the center ice, he's over the Badger blue line, and he's stopped by Bobby Bogdan, and Russ Kennedy fires it over to Greg Price. Price gets away from a check by Dumarez, and he makes his way out to center ice. Now Barry Manuel fires it in the corner as Greg Price comes up with the loose puck and is back to Rod Howell. There's a weak shot, and that's gloved by Tony Walsh. Out of Flyers, fires it up to Dumarez. Kennedy off the boards to Bobby Bogdan, to Barry Manuel at center ice, and he's taken out of the play by Ray Hefferman, and an elbow penalty coming up to Hefferman.
Is he going to be called either charging or elbowing? He ran probably 25, 30 feet of Manuel, and he stuck the elbow up at the last minute. Kind of a 40s penalty to take at this juncture. You're down four goals at 6-2. You're in the third period, and this is a must game for either team. It's the turning point for Vikings are for this series. You're up either up or down 2-1 with Doomsday coming tomorrow for possibly one of them.
All the Flyers will go on the power play. Great Russ Kennedy. Kennedy back to Bobby Bogdan. There's a shot and a big pad saved by Tony Walsh. Al Bradbury feeds the pass up to Tony Hocko. He's over the Badger blue line. That's a shot goal and that hits the side of the net. Rod Howell taken out of the play by Tony Hocko. And the puck is back to Howell out to Bobby Bogdan. Bogdan at his own blue line, watched by Bradbury, who fires it up to Price over to Kennedy. Kennedy back to Howell on the blue line. It's in the Craig Tuck. Back to Howell. There's a shot. And that was just wide. Alley will freeze it against the side of the net. And we'll have a face-off to the left of goaltender Tony Wald.
We'll score 6-2, and the fans are really getting into this game now. As I said before, they sense that that this game is in the books for the home team. Big Tony Hocko on that last shift that was knocking everybody over in sight. He's pretty strong on his skates.
Now Greg Price loses the draw. Tony Walsh frees it once again. And Sellers and Tuck have a few words.
There's quite a difference in size did in Price and Tuck and Manuel out there alongside of Hocko and John Goss and those guys. They're big and strong, but the boys are a little faster. That'll make up for the size.
All the Bombers lead it by a score of 6-2. This game is brought to you by Cable Atlantic, Grand Falls, Windsor. On the faceoff, John Goss shoots it down in Badger territory, and Roger Kennedy shoots it off to Bobby Bugden at his own blue line, makes his way to center ice. Fires it in around the boards, and Russ Kennedy back in the keyed loader. He's watched by Brent Sellers. Al Loader out in front, and George Penny keeps it in to Bobby Bugden. There's a weak shot, and that's steered aside by Tony Walsh, and he'll cover up once again, not taking any chances whatsoever.
No, Ted, right now Badger are on the power play, five men to four. And Tony Walsh is anything that comes handy now, he's just grabbing it and holding on.
Also like to mention, Jack, that the coach of the Flatrock Flyers is also the mayor of Flatrock, Joe Maynard, and he certainly puts a lot into community sport. And he's also coaches in a lot of minor hockey tournaments. Now there's a shot by George Penny, score!
That Tony Walsh misplayed the puck. That was a weak shot by Penny. It was bouncing, Tony Walsh just missed it completely.
Well, it wasn't a real hard shot by George Penny. It just seemed to elude Tony Walsh there, and the Bombers now go up by a score of 7-2. And the fans, Jack, are really it up there now.
They sensed for a while now that this game probably was going to end in their favor.
Now Stretch Hayden. Fires it off for Jeff Sullivan, picks up the loose puck, and it's back at center ice. Now George Penny fires it in the Flyers' end. 14:52 the time of the goal by George Penny from Bobby Bugden. Now John Goss fires it up to, I think, Bobby Osmond. Now it's number 21, Bobby Furlong. Bobby Furlong seeing his first shift of the night for the Flat Rock Flyers.
Well, George Penny has scored here in the third period, Ted. George Penny has played a real strong game all night. I think he set the tone early. He played really well in the first period, and the team seemed to follow in his footsteps.
On the faceoff, Jeff Sullivan. And they freeze it along the boards. Once again, now Yubi Hollett and Bobby Furlan go at it. Now on the Flat Rock Flyers, they sprawl on the ice. I don't know what happened there, Jack.
No, I didn't quite see it either, Ted, but I think he's just bluffing there.
That's number 70, Ray Hefferman.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with him now, and I don't think... The referee, I don't think, is going to have any of this. He's going to call penalties, but not to the nature of what 17 Ray Hefferman wanted.
Well, Ray Hefferman, a good defenseman. He tried to pull a Claude Lemieux stunt there, but I don't think it worked. So Ray just gets up and laughs it off.
I think Badger are going to get a penalty, but it's going to be the minor nature, I think.
Well, Burt Little's in the penalty box, along with Yubi Hollett.
Yes, they've been assessed two penalties on the play, so
Maybe it did work.
And now our referee, Jeff Wells, is called over to the timekeeper's box. I guess they'll try and just see what's going on and get it sorted out. Our little lineup for the face-off, Craig Tuck shoots it in, Flyers in, and Steve Cleary. Cleary circles around behind his own net, makes his way up to his own blue line, to Bobby Furlan. Here's Joey Maynard, and he failed to get around Roger Kennedy. Now Hefferman couldn't keep the puck in, and is back in Flyer territory, Steve Cleary. Once again, up to center ice, gets around Craig Tuck. Fires it in the corner, and Jeff Sullivan behind the Badger net, taken out of the play by number 15, Bobby Bogdan. Now Tuck, intercepted by Hefferman. He makes his way in front. There's Joey Maynard, he scores! Joey Maynard, number 14, puts the Flyers back on the board once again. And now they trail by four.
7-3, Ted, and there's still a substantial amount of time left in one of those two penalties that was called at the same time. It was a good goal there by Maynard. Coming maybe a bit.
Once again, he fires it in the Badger end. But Roger Kennedy leaves it for George Penny. Penny up to Barry Manuel, a rink-wide pass to Greg Price. Up the Tuck. Fires it off the boards, and Greg Price failed to pick it up. Now there's a shot by Manuel. That was just wide. Bobby Bogdan keeps the puck in. And now Bradbury fires it up for Bobby Bogdan. Will make the play for the Bombers as he shoots it over the blue line to Price. There's a shot. That was wide and right back to center ice. Now Wayne Sullivan. This pass is stopped by Kevin Parsons. And Bobby Bogdan fires it in behind the Flyers' net. Hefferman makes his way up to his own blue line to Kevin Parsons. He overskates the puck. Now you'll be hollered over to Sullivan. There's a shot and a big save by Tony Walsh.
Yes, Taylor, a big save there by Tony Walsh again. And now we have him going at it again in the corner. And again, nothing is going to come out of this. Just a bit of pushing and shoving. But Tony Walsh came up big here again on Hubert Hollis and Davey Jacobs. So Davey took the shot. And Walsh
Sullivan is in all alone. There's a weak shot. And Kennedy gloves that and fires it off the glass. Our Heffermans. Up to Kevin Parsons. Over the Badger blue line. And that's stopped by Wayne Sullivan. Sully. Up to Hubert Hollett. Back to Sullivan. Over to Rod Howell. Still at his own blue line. Fires it out to center ice. And Yubi Holler fires it up to Bogdan. Bogdan fires it in the Flyers' end, and that's stopped by John Goss. Now Ron Howell. Stopped by Ray Hefferman. And Dumarez. Up ahead to Eddie Oates. Oates taken out of the play by Keith Loader. And Roger Kennedy fires it off the glass for Keith Loader. Piece up loose putt. Fires it out to center ice. Now there's Dumarez, a shot. And a big save by Roger Kennedy, and he'll hold on for the faceoff.
As Roger came up that time looking behind him, Teddy, he thought that puck got by him, but it didn't. I was informed by our the president of the Biotic League there that Dave Butt did get a shift earlier in this period. He's more observant than I thought he was.
Well, Dave Butt wearing number 16 tonight. For the Badger Bombers, now from the faceoff. Puck is out to Dumarez. It's inside the Badger blue line where Russ Kennedy winds up behind his own blue line, makes his way to center ice. That's intercepted by Eddie Oates. Eddie Oates taken out of the play by Stretch Hayden. Oates back in the pedal, fires it out front. There's a shot, a weak shot by Terry Humber, and Kennedy will hold on once again.
Did I had to be in all fairness to the president of our center and immediate faculty, Rob Bucker. He's done a tremendous job over the years in looking after this league. You need people like this around here. Except for people like Ralph Foster, you'd have no hockey, probably, you know.
Well, Jack, Ralph Foster is a one-man executive in this Central Biotic Hockey League, And when you run a whole six-team lead by yourself, that goes to show how well things can be done by one man. And Ralph Foster is a good example of that. There's a shot by Sellers that's stopped in front by Ross Kennedy. Now Keith Loader. Just outside his own blue line, back to George Penny. Over to Stretch Hayden, he fanned on the shot. And Bradbury fires it over to Terry Humber, up to Warren Sullivan. And Keith Loader picks up the loose puck in his own blue line. Now Sullivan trying to get around George Penny, fires it in front. And Bradbury failed to tuck it home. Now Steve Burns fires it out to center ice for Sellers. For the Flyers, shoots it in the corner behind Roger Kennedy. George Penny fires it off the boards and down the Flyers' end as he makes a change on the play. Al Sellers up to his own blue line. And he loses it. And Warren Sullivan goes down heavily from a check from Barry Manuel just outside center ice. And he's hurting on that one. Now Terry Humber behind his own net. Up to Tony Huckle, leaves it for Humber. He gets around Craig Price. And now Wayne Sullivan. Fires it over to Bobby Bogdan. And he just gets it out over his own line. Roger Kennedy fires it off the glass and hits Bobby Furlong in the face mask. And they have a face off just outside the Badger blue line.
Ted, I was more impressed with the play of number six, Barry Manuel. This year, this is the first time I've seen Barry Manuel play. He's deceptive in the size, and a lot of people have tried to take Barry Manuel down, but he's ended up taking them down.
On the face-off, there's a shot wide of Kennedy, right in front, and it was on an offside call. And thrown out of the game for fighting, along with Robbie Penny of the Badger Bombers. Al Rod Howell at his own blue line, fires it up to Barry Manuel, it's a two-line offside. And now Tony Walsh. Tony Walsh is in a mix-up in the corner. He didn't like the Bomber player come at him. And we'll see who the Bomber player is. Now is Tony Walsh.
Did Tony Walsh left his crease and really went into the corner. And he's still at it. I guess he sensed that this game is out of hand. I don't know how this rule stands now in the last 10 minutes of a hockey game, proper hockey game.
Well, Jack, that rule doesn't apply right now, because right now we're playing under CAHA rules in this Hurdle Memorial Final. And it doesn't matter if you fight under the 10-minute mark. You get thrown out of the game, but you're not suspended for the next one. That's just the Central Biotic Hockey League rule.
I think that was young Tuck, or Ted.
It is Craig Tuck, number 8.
Well, he's been a thorn in the side of Flatrock all night.
And now I think Tony Walsh is thrown out of the game. Tony Walsh leads the game for the Flatrock Flyers. And we'll await the call.
Now we start to get litter onto the ice, Ted. And this is on call for, and must be 5 or 6 minutes left.
Well, Jack, we were just informed the reason for the delay in the game. Blair Langmead, who had been taken out of the game after the first period, was back in the dressing room undressed, and he had to redress again to come back in this game after Tony Walsh got thrown out.
You know, I must say on his behalf, it didn't take him very long, because not to put on all the goalie equipment.
Off on the face-off, Dumarez makes his way up to center ice. He's over the Badger blue line. Turns, fires the rink-wide pass to John Goss and George Penny. Fires it out the board to Keith Loader. It's a partial break for Loader. There's a shot and a big save by Langmead. Al Sellers crosses dangerously in front of his own net up the center ice to Terry Pedley. He's over the Badger blue line to Dumarez. Dumarez, a rink wide pass to Sellers. That's intercepted by Ross Kennedy. Now Ross Kennedy. There's a shot and he was just wide. Now Pedal. Failed to pick up the loose puck. As Stretch Hayden picks up the puck outside of his own blue line and Dumarez intercepts. He's over the Badger blue line. Over to Terry Pedal and he failed to pick up the pass. Now Hayden fires it up to center ice. Gets around Hefferman, over to Ross Kennedy. Kennedy back to Hayden, a weak shot, and Langmead leaves it for Hefferman behind his own net. Hefferman over to Steve Cleary. Cleary back to Hefferman at his own blue line, up the center ice to Jeff Sullivan. Sullivan back to Hefferman, that's stopped by Yubi Hollett. Now Hollett, he's over the Flyers blue line, watched by Steve Cleary. And taken out of the play up on the glass by Cleary. Al Davy Jacobs fires it out in front, but that hits Cleary's skate and is back behind the Flyers' net. Al Jeff Sullivan comes up with a loose puck, fires it off the boards, and Ron Howell lets a shot go. And that's in front, and Jeff Sullivan picks up the loose puck and is back to center ice. Over to Joey Maynard. Maynard, watched by Bobby Bogdan, fires it aside the net. And Sullivan and Davy Jacobs. There's a loose puck and Yubi Hollett leads it for Rod Howell. Bogdan up the center ice. Feeds a pass up to Bert Sullivan on a two-line pass and the Bombers will be called for icing. Rink-wide pass over to Bobby Bogdan. Fires it up to Barry Manuel and Sellers takes over. Rod Howell. Back at his own blue line. Back to Yubi Hollett. Over to Greg Price. There's a shot, and that's stopped by Ray Hefferman.
1 minute in the third period. 1 minute.
1 minute left in this game, and the Bombers beat it by 7-3. As the puck comes back over to Bombers' blue line, and Rod Howell shoots it over to Bobby Bogdan. Up to Craig Loader, now Steve Cleary. Over to Ray Hefferman. Hefferman makes his way at his own blue line, gets around Dave Jacobs, pucks up over the Badger blue line, and Bobby Bogdan fires it back out to Craig Loader. Hefferman fires it behind the Badger net. About 30 seconds left in this game. And Bobby Bogdan killing off time now. Back to Rod Howell, and he fires it up to the Flyers blue line. Steve Cleary at his own blue line. Hefferman, and there's the buzzer, and the Bombers win this one, Jack, by a score of 7-3 as they lead this Herder Memorial Final by. Jack by a score of 7-3 as they lead this Herder Memorial Final by 2-1.
The tender full marks for the victory tonight.
Well, hello again, everybody. Welcome back to the Badger Stadium. It's game four in the Herder Memorial Trophy Final between the Badger Bombers and the Flatrock Flyers. Last night, game three.